A new type of rocket is set to launch from the Cape this week. Get this, the company made a rocket mostly with a 3D printer. Can you believe that? So over here, we actually have a picture of the rocket. This is made with mostly 3D printer. As West 2's Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler tells us, this is a first for the industry.
Relativity Space hopes to blaze a new trail in commercial spaceflight Wednesday by launching its Terran 1 rocket for the very first time. The startup has been working out at Launch Complex 16 on the Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. Its leadership has roots in commercial spaceflight leaders, SpaceX and Blue Origin.
In some ways, I suppose we could once again thank SpaceX for providing a whole new generation of rocket engineers to do the next generation of entrepreneurship in space and space launch.
The mission is called Good Luck, Have Fun. Like SpaceX's Falcon 9 booster, the Relativity rockets will be reusable. The company says because of the way they're manufactured, printed, and the streamlined supply chain, they can create a rocket from raw material within 60 days. The focus for commercial spaceflight companies is to drive down costs. 3D printing rockets, if successful, could do that in a big way.
But it does show that there's innovation taking place in the development of new rockets and ways to get to space affordably, which is really the bottom line.
But the complexity of spaceflight is deep, and the new 3D manufacturing is only one of the systems being tested on Wednesday.
Yeah, even if it's not successful, we don't necessarily have to say that, gee, it didn't work because it's 3D printed. You know, it's a brand new rocket, brand new system, brand new organization.
The stakes are high, and pulling it off could determine which direction the company will go.
And if you're, you know, a new player in the commercial space industry, you want to prove to your potential customers that you've got a viable vehicle. And so if it works, then you've done that.
But if it does fail, hopefully the data shows what needs to be done to get to the next step and try again. On the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.